Hello viewers, in the previous video we discussed about compressibility and bulk modulus topics. To watch that video, please click the suggested video. Today in this video we are going to know about surface tension and what will be the surface tension on liquid droplet, hollow bubble and liquid jet. Now let's know about surface tension. The tensile force acting on the surface of a liquid in contact with a gas or on the surface between two immersible liquids such that the contact surface behaves like a membrane under tension is known as surface tension. The magnitude of this force per unit length of the free surface will have the same values as the surface energy per unit area. The units of surface tension are Newton per meter or kg force per meter. The phenomena of surface tension is explained by figure shown here. Consider three molecules named as A, B and C in a mass of liquid. The molecule A is attracted in all directions equally by the surrounding liquid molecules. Thus, the resulting force acting on the molecule A is zero. But when we observe molecule B, which is near to the free surface, is acted upon by upward and downward forces, which are unbalanced. Thus, a net resultant force on molecule B is acting in the downward direction, as well as molecule C also experience a resultant downward force as it is situated on the free surface of liquid. All the molecules on the free surface experience a downward force. Thus, the free surface on the liquid acts like a very film under tension. And this phenomenon is known as surface tension. Now, let us know about surface tension on liquid droplet. To explain this, let us consider a small spherical droplet of a liquid of radius as R. On the entire surface of the liquid, the tensile force due to surface tension will be acting. Let sigma be the surface tension of a liquid, P be the pressure intensity inside the liquid droplet, D is the diameter of a liquid droplet. Now, let us assume that the droplet is cut into two halves. The force acting on one half, for suppose it is left half, will be tensile force due to surface tension acting around the circumference of the cut portion as shown here. And the tensile force should be the product of the surface tension and circumference of a liquid droplet. And the pressure force acting on the area will be the product of pressure intensity inside the liquid droplet and the area of the liquid droplet. That is, pressure force is equal to P into pi by 4 d square. Here, we are writing the area of circle because the pressure intensity acting inside the liquid droplet having circular cross section. These two forces will be equal and opposite under equilibrium conditions. Then tensile force is equal to pressure force sigma into pi d, that is equal to P into pi by 4 d square. After simplifications, we will get intensity of pressure P is equal to 4 sigma by d. Now, from this equation, it clearly shows that if the diameter of liquid droplet decreases, then the pressure intensity increases. Now, let us see the surface tension on a hollow bubble. Here, a hollow bubble is like a soap bubble in air, has two surfaces in contact with air, one inside and other outside. Thus, the two surfaces are subjected to surface tension. In such case, pressure intensity is equal to the 2 times of tensile force because the surface tension acting inside and outside of the hollow bubble. Then P into pi d square by 4 is equal to 2 into sigma into pi d. After simplification, we will get P is equal to 8 sigma by d. And finally, what will be the surface tension on a liquid jet? Consider a liquid jet having diameter d and length L as shown here. Consider the equilibrium of semi-jet. We have pressure force is equal to pressure intensity into area of semi-jet. And force due to surface tension will be sigma into 2L. Here, 2L means the surface tension acts on surface of liquid jet on both sides as shown here. Then equating forces, we will get P into L into D, that is equal to sigma into 2L. Therefore, pressure intensity will be sigma into 2L by L into D. That is, finally, P is equal to 2 sigma by D. Thank you for watching this video.